the rainbow bridge of Asgard, where the booming heavens roar. You'll behold in breathless wonder the God of Thunder, mighty Thor.
To the great halls of celestial Asgard, a royal voice is raised in protest.
Mighty Odin, all-powerful king of the gods.
Sire, 'tis the Norn queen.
I beg the return of my magical Norn stones, stolen by your god of menace, Loki.
Their powers could be used for evils unbounded.
Bring Loki before me.
I hid them.
Sire, I will fetch the stones and return them to the Norn queen.
Have a care, my son. This day, none can call on me for aid. I will be deep in the sleep of life, the ritual I must endure for one full day each year to preserve my immortality.
Sleep well, my father. The Norn stones will be back with their mystic queen ere you awaken.
You will find them in a pouch beneath that rock.
In that mountain, Loki? You are indeed a fool, hiding those magic stones so near the hidden tomb of the Destroyer.
He will learn which of us is the fool. This very day, while Odin sleeps, I shall achieve my ultimate triumph over Thor.
Ah, that must be the rock. Yes, the pouch. For once my wicked half-brother has spoken the truth.
But even as the Thunder God examines the fabled Norn stones...
Ha! If 'tis to be done, it must be now. The renegade hunter, he shall be my puppet. I have but to control his mind. Look, ahead of you, hunter, the Thunder God himself. What a prize. Shoot, hunter.
The Thunder God. But no, not a mere bullet on such a target. For him, this anesthetic shell, it can stop a herd of elephants.
Yes! Fire! Fire!
The mighty Thor, felled by the one weapon his strength cannot resist, an instant action sleep gas. Thor, my captive. What does it all mean? The God of Thunder, and these Viking relics too, all within the shadows of that strange mountain bad. Magic must not go near bad mountain. Still that voodoo talk. Somehow I've got a feeling I should investigate that mountain.
Yes, hunter. And my magic will unveil a page from a bygone world.
Oh, mountain. The blast wakens Thor.
Oh, no. Not the crypt of the Destroyer. No human must come within arm's length of him.
The dazed hunter stares. Where the bleak mountain had been, a temple or a tomb. Some strange force seems to be drawing me. Unable to resist the eerie attraction of the great structure, the hunter edges slowly, hesitantly, into the silent sepulcher.
Could it be the tomb of that native legend? Of a metal monster without a life of his own, waiting for ages until...
No, he must not know. If he gets within arm's length of the Destroyer, his brain energy will activate it. His very life will be drawn from his body. It is the Temple of Darkness, built by Odin ages ago to hold and hide the life-hungry monster for all eternity. That sinister force exposed it now. If only I am in time.
Closer! Hurry, hunter! Move within arm's length! It is done! The spirit transfer! The life of the man has left his mortal body, and the Destroyer lives again!
That sound! By the stars of Asgard! His body stands rigid. I am too late.
Back, Thunder God! Away from my mortal body!
The Destroyer, you live again!
To do what I was created for! Destroy!
the golden gates of Asgard it must not be. All-wise Odin placed you here to shield humanity from any future danger. You must return to the endless sleep that he decreed. I will stop you. I must.
It is already too late. Even the power of your hammer is as nothing to me.
He speaks true. He has the strength to wield my mighty weapon, and yet, if I fail to stop him here, all Earth will be his helpless prey.
His own mighty Ulu hammer turned against him. How can Thor win or even survive?
My triumph at last! My half-brother Thor will be destroyed by the Destroyer! And those who have scoffed at Loki will change their tune! Norn Queen, now what do you say? I have released the Destroyer upon Thor!
Have you lost your wit, Prince of Evil? How dare you defy Odin's edict?
What edict?
Look! Upon my magic mist, the moment recreated.
Verily, I do know Thor's journey doth take him near the crypt of the Destroyer. 'Twas I who buried him neath a granite mountain, and 'tis I who will impose swift death on whoever frees the indestructible menace.
Those were Odin's words within the hour.
And within another, Thor's life will surely end. I cannot stop the Destroyer. Now, only Odin has such power.
And you, Knave, will pay with your life.
No, no. Thor may have a chance. See? He regains his hammer.
It is mine again. But hold. The very earth trembles. What new attack is this?
A bolt of limitless force to disarm you again.
My hammer, sliced in two. I will still battle, even with no weapon.
No, Thor. If you die, then Loki dies. Only Odin can stop the Destroyer.
Halt! It is forbidden. None may enter Odin's chamber.
Silence! You speak to Loki, son of Odin, brother of Thor.
Nay, Prince of Menace, though the heavens tremble, Odin's immortality must be preserved by the ritual of the sleep of life.
Fast, lords! Will be a death sleep for your thunder god if Odin is not told.
You lie, master of trickery. All Asgard knows your hateful Thor. Plan your wild schemes in here and count the hours till Odin awakens.
I possess every destructive force in the universe. You have no chance, son of Odin.
The Norn stones. Perhaps I can gain advantage with their levitating powers.
I'll put an end to your leaping and dodging with magnetic force to bring you down, and a liquefying force to entrap and hold you.
The liquefied molecules are hard again. I am trapped before him.
If Thor dies, I die too. Somehow I must save him. But even my powers of enchantment cannot melt these walls. 'Tis not fair, not fair. I am doomed, all because of Thor. The Destroyer is beyond me. But if the mind of the hunter still lives within him, perhaps my mental powers can reach him.
You struggle in vain, fool. No power in the universe can loosen those.